2014 Youth Olympic Games weightlifting, the men's 85 kg class final from the Nanjing International Expo Center Hall, getting set for competition here. It's going to be a small field, but it should be an exciting contest.
Yeah, small but quality, and there's not a lot between them, is there, when you have a look at their entry weights in this 85-kilo event. And they've all had to weigh in, of course, a couple of hours prior to ensure that they make the weight, and fortunately all have been successful. But just the five athletes to battle it out for the gold, silver and bronze, but not a lot of difference in their entry totals. The lowest entry total at 310 kilos, the highest at 330. I know that sounds a bit at 20 kilos, but you know, we've seen some gaps of 70 and 80 kilos. And also, we looking at those entry totals, you've got to think that those entry totals will be within their grasp, and who knows how much more some of them may have when they're put under the pressure of needing to go up to try and claim a medal. Should be good stuff. And of course, these boys are getting big. You know, they're the second highest weight class after this. It's just anyone over 85 kilos. So, you know, effectively just heavyweight on up from there. So a relatively quiet warm-up area, because there's only the five of them. But these boys would be well and truly warmed up by now. They're just really starting to focus on what's going on. The young lifter from Islamic Republic of Iran on screen there, for Alvand, and he has an entry total of 320, which will put him thereabouts. Wong Song Won from the Republic of Korea, his entry total of 310. The Uzbek at 325. The Hudbed. And I think this is the Egyptian. It was a great lifting from his countrywoman yesterday. She was really quite spectacular. And he's entered at around 310, and the Russian is the highest of the lifters in terms of his entry total. That's Gugayev, and he has an entry total of 330. There are the body weights, as we mentioned. They've weighed in about 90 minutes or so ago, and they're not far from being brought out and introduced to the crowd. And as always, we do go from lowest weight to highest weight. And if the athletes do lift consecutively, they get 2 minutes. If they're following each other, then there's 1 minute between lifts. That's to start the lift, not to complete the lift. But of course, in weightlifting, you hope it doesn't take too long to complete it anyway. You don't want that weight sitting on your shoulders for too long. All about power and speed weightlifting, as these men are about to be introduced to the crowd here at the Expo Center, which is also, it's a massive area. It's also host to boxing and taekwondo.
So here is the first of the competitors coming up. We have one each from the Islamic Republic of Iran, one from Republic of Korea, from Egypt, from the Russian Federation, and from Uzbekistan, forming up into order for the march in. Always a very formal introduction for the competitors and officials at a weightlifting event, and you'll get to see that, and the crowd will enjoy it, as they will enjoy seeing themselves on screen.
Oh, you're going to love that, haven't you? The youngsters, some of them just go nuts, and it's been very cute all the way along. They've been entertained by the mascots out here in the last few minutes as well, and some nice traditional dance. Very ancient city, of course, Nanjing was the capital of the Ming Dynasty. And here are our athletes. And they're big men, aren't they? Look, you know, just 17. The boy out the front. The next one's 16, then 16. That's gonna be big boys when they grow up.
So So the first up is Reza Baralvand from the Islamic Republic of Iran.
And we expect him to start his snatch at 138 kilos. He has a combined total of 320 kilos with his entry. It's a big spot to be starting a snatch, isn't it? At 138 kgs. Wong Shong Wong, 310, his entry, and he's down at the moment, listed to start his snatch at 135. The Egyptian, Shosha, at 310, and down to start his snatch at 140. Getag Gagayev of the Russian Federation, scheduled to start the snatch at 150, has a combined total, the top entry total at 330. And the young lad from Uzbekistan, his snatch is set to start at 140. He has a combined entry total of 325. If you are watching weightlifting for the first time in Nanjing 2014, it's all about the combined total. There is no individual medals for the snatch and the clean and jerk, which means, of course, that if you don't get yourself into the contest in the snatch, which is why you want to have a conservative start, you're out. And in a field of five, when all of them are thereabouts in terms of the potential medals, you really do need to take a conservative approach. As our central referee comes out and leading out our technical officials, they'll be introduced to the crowd, followed by the jury.
Yes, they all have impressive titles, the officials for the contest tonight. Central referee, referees, reserve referee, chief marshal, timekeepers, technical controllers, and doctor to the left, Dr. Michael Irani from Great Britain.
There's our center referee, the next two referees, the right and left referee from France and China, respectively. There is a reserve referee as well from Egypt, as the Chinese referee is being introduced now. And of course the marshals have a very important job. Hopefully should be less busy for them this evening, but as the athletes are normally of a field of 12 or so, and they're jockeying for positions in terms of what they're declaring for their weights. And there's a bit of that, there's a bit of tactics involved. You can force the other lifter to go back out when perhaps he's not expecting to have to go back out, if you choose to go up and he's left with the next weight. But if you push that particular envelope too far, you can find yourself out of the postcard, down to the competition, if you can't make your own lift.
And sometimes there are discrepancies by the referees, and the juries then call them to discuss their decisions, and a decision is then handed down by the jury.
Yeah, we had it happen yesterday. There was an event where what looked to be a successful lift, it was certainly given a successful lift by the referees for the bronze medal, was then dismissed by the jury. And we had one boy who had been celebrating, and he was shattered, and another boy who had been shattered suddenly celebrating. He thought he was in fourth, took the bronze medal. And here are the jurors being introduced.
Yes, sometimes those referees who vote red on a lift are asked to justify their calls. But sometimes those who vote with the white light for a proper lift are asked to explain their decisions too.
Yeah, it's when you've got three people so close watching the same lift, and it happens so quickly. We've seen earlier today, it can happen. You'll get what you'd call a split decision. You'll have two going one way, and perhaps with the white lights, and one going with the red light. Nine times out of ten, if it isn't the obvious losing your footing and not getting yourself set at the end of the clean and jerk, nine times out of ten, it's all about losing your elbow and then re-extending the arm. But that can be so small.
Here's the handshake between the various parts, just to complete these formalities.
Yes, the technical officials are all wished luck by the jury, and they'll then actually stop and take a photo for posterity as well. which they'll pose for in a moment, and then the countdown clock will begin to the actual competition.
So so what you said before about boxing, split decision, using a boxing term, using a musical term, all of this handshaking and teamwork together means they're, in musical sense, singing off the same song sheet.
That's right. It's well choreographed as well. You know, the other thing about these officials, they, of course, as is in the Olympic Charter, these sports are run by the individual governing bodies, but these are people that have worked tirelessly for years, as we're now back looking at some of the athletes, but tirelessly for years to be at an event like this, because they've turned up in a volunteer capacity over and over and over again at local competitions in their home countries. So it's a great honour for them, and good to see that they are here and posing for photographs and so forth at these Youth Olympic Games.
So these in the crowd, these people in the crowd are looking across to where the officials are getting set. Meanwhile, out the back, here is the Iranian lifter, Reza Baralvand.
Well, you're just mucking around with that much weight. He's probably had 100 kgs there, and he's just throwing it around like it's a toothpick. Looks like a group of school kids, perhaps.
The introduction of these cameras in the back or behind the stage has been a fantastic thing for the showpiece event, the showpiece display and presentation of weightlifting. It's completely altered the way weightlifting is presented and people's perception of what goes into it.
Absolutely, because they suddenly realise that there is such a drama playing its part in the back as these, you know, athletes are wondering, oh, can I push that far or do I need to rush back out? We've had athletes in this competition here in Nanjing actually had to sprint when they've realised that that they're suddenly there, but they thought there were four other athletes that would be lifting before them, and all of them have lifted their total, and they've had to run out, and one Colombian boy missed it entirely. But there's so much about this particular sport that relies on pace. They are really quite dynamic, fast twitch muscle fibre athletes. Without that, you can't be a weightlifter. This young boy from Poland, he was on the he's second from the left, was a tremendous entertainer when he lifted a few days ago.
There, in essence, is the basis of a successful competition, explosive.
Yeah, and
speed.
He looked good in the snatch there, didn't he? But again, he had 102.5 kilos there. So it's a long way from where he's going to be lifting in a moment. This is just about getting the nerves out. I'm just looking down at the clock. We should have a start in about 2.5 minutes. The Dr. Irani is coming back out. The three referees are yet to appear and take their positions. So we've got, what have we got here in terms of age spread? We've got four 16-year-olds and a 17-year-old. Number of 16-year-olds turning 17 this year, as those three do. That one does. Yep, so they all turn 17 this year. So they're all turning 17 at some stage this year, but at the moment, four of them are just 16. Our first lifter out is has already turned 17. He turned 17 on what we refer to in Australia as April Fool's Day, on the 1st of April. Get ready to wave to the camera. Look up. You're on.
Interesting to go out the back just a wee while ago and just talk with the competitors. One of the coaches that was coaching the Hungarian lifter in the women's competition earlier on this day's competition is now helping one of the competitors in this competition, even though Hungary, where he comes from, does not have an entry here in this event.
Yeah, it's wonderful, isn't it? And same thing was happening last night with a lady coach from Papua New Guinea helping out an athlete from Tonga. It's good to see, because many of them have been unable to bring specialist coaches with them. So we're going to start with 135 kilos on the board. That's at least where it's looking like we're going to start with the fellow from Korea, Wong Song Wong.
So there's the weights going on. The red ones are 25 kgs. They're called big reds. If you see them, it has been said that some athletes sometimes get a bit spooked when they see some of the big reds come on. It's a battle of mental as well as physical coordination and confidence.
You've got to believe you can. There's no, you can't approach the bar with any sort of hesitation whatsoever. You've got to think that it's doable. And look, these early lifts certainly should be.
He's got a couple of big reds, as we see.
Nice technique.
So, in fact, he's going to be the first one out, according to the flashing red light you see up at the top of the screen there. So he's just having a last run through Huang Songwan. And here he comes.
I tell you, this truncated number, you know, five lifters, it puts a lot of pressure on these guys. There's not a lot of time to go back and relax and think your way through if you have missed a list and then decide to go further up. So it's really important that they all get off to a good start.
So the belt is in place, giving some confidence and support at the lift. Here comes Huang Songwan of Korea, the Republic of Korea, to get this competition for the 85 kg group. Gold, silver and bronze up for grabs for five competitors. So this is the snatch. Look at that. Comfortable opening lift for Huang Songwan.
Yeah, it sure was. He looked really good in those couple of warm-up lifts that our cameras captured behind the scenes. And that was a pretty comfortable total for him. It'll be interesting to see where he goes from here. At the moment, the next lower, as he looked, that's a lovely lift. There's absolutely no movement anywhere in terms of his... he didn't have to split the feet. He's currently at 135. Now we have a lift at 140 and 139 in terms of next entry lift. So he's pushed it to 140, which means he doesn't have to come back out. But of course, the other lifter could say, "No, well, hang on, I'm going to go further than 140 or 139." So at the moment, we're looking at the boy from Iran who will lift at 139.
So here he comes, Reza Baralvand. 139 kgs. Looks over at the timer. It's over to the right of the screen where you're watching. And 30 seconds to go. Siren comes on.
Yeah, that was a pretty comfortable lift for him too. Started with the legs really quite narrow. They looked to be inside his shoulders and then punched them out just out past the shoulders, but looked to be even inside the shoulder. I'll have another look at that later, but as he took his position, he pushed them back out outside the shoulders, but he was quite close together with those feet.
And so coming out now is Mohamed Shosha from Egypt.
Been some good lifting from the Egyptians so far in other parts of the competition. So he's also at 140.
Oh dear, that's a surprise.
Here it is. It's well within his best. Maybe some nerves. But he's going to feel that that's not just a big miss, but an opportunity missed as well. Just to get himself set. he now has a big question to ask about where he goes next.
And so coming in to the competition now, the second to last lifters for Hodbek Sobirov.
Who was at 140.
Straight up.
Yeah, no problem with that, was there? He, again, wonderful economy of movement, really quick to get it into position and a good leg drive. He looks as if he had at least another 10 kilos in him. Wouldn't be surprised to see him go up by 5 and 5. That was a very good lift.
So here's Wang coming out again. Huang Sunwan.
Bar still set at 140. This is his second lift. He was successful at 135.
Oh dear, he's missed there quite badly.
Yeah, that's a real technical error, that one. Again, this isn't a problem with the weight. This, he just never got himself anywhere near in position. He looked so good in the warm-up, as we mentioned before, but look at that. This is way in front of himself and didn't get his body down low enough.
On the other hand, he can't get down too low. The only part that can touch the floor in the lift is the feet.
Yep.
As soon as any part, say, of the backside touches the ground in the snatch, here's Shosha.
Well, he'll be happy with that, having missed at 140, to have now got himself on the board.
Mohammed Shosha.
Yeah, he just had a bit of a focus problem, a bit of a brain snap with the first attempt, and that was a really nice lift.
And so they're pleased, those supporters waiting in the wings, the coaching staff. So this is a critical lift now for Huang. He missed badly at 140k, and this is his last in the snatch. We're kind of racing through the competition here with only 5 competitors. That's bound to happen.
Ooh, I think you'll find as well. Just have a look at his right arm in this attempt. That's unfortunate for him. So he's going to have to be settled with 135 kilos, and he's the first man out of the snatch.
He's done 150. Yeah. So he's got a few problems, hasn't he?
That elbow broke as well. Even if he'd got that lift, you know, I think that may have been why he put it down so quickly. Even if he'd got that lift, it would have been a non-lift. So that's, yeah, he's going to be really disappointed with that result. But look, who knows how he's been in training of late. But as you say, he's lifted 150. To go out at 135 would be...
Okay, here's Baralvand. There's the support for him. Islamic Republic of Iran.
Yeah, 5 kilo lift from 139 to 144. Gee, that's unlucky. He was quick to get it there and just got it back too far behind his head. We'll be able to see this pretty well in the replay. So 139 is where he's sitting at the moment. And he got this quickly into position. He had his body into good position as well, but just had the hands back too far behind the head. They know it.
So his shush are coming in now.
Successful at 140. The bar now set at 144.
Sometimes you feel like this, that you could speak every language just to catch up with how they're encouraging. Oh, gee, there's another one. So, do you think these guys have gone out too big?
I don't know. I think the quickness of the competition having to come out so quickly could well be an issue. But he's going to walk away now with 140. He missed his first lift at 140 and nailed it quite easily. Went up the 4 kilos. So he's taking 140 through into the clean and jerk. Now the Russian sitting watching all of this, he's scheduled to start lifting at 150. This is the final attempt.
Yes, final attempt for Retalvad of Iran. Okay.
Already missed at 144.
Yep. Fought it beautifully.
He sure did. He's got 3 white lights too. That's a terrific effort after missing at 144. He's got himself thereabouts. He's going to be finishing no worse than third after the snatch. And when you've already missed this sort of weight.
See how low he got? Nearly touched the floor, but drove up hard from there.
Yeah, and look, he spent some time getting himself steady, didn't he? That's a real fight to have to do that. Second attempt now, this time at 145, successful at 140. You'll get the 30-second buzzer in a moment.
Of course, 30 seconds would seem like a lifetime out there. They do occasionally have a glance across at it, but there's tons of time left. He's got 145 on the bar. How about that one there? Johnny stepped forward and then lifted it. Different technique.
Yep, and it wasn't as pretty as his first lift, that's for sure, but it was legal. And that's right up there now, isn't it, at 145. But gee, Gagayev must be pretty confident. He's still sitting back watching all of this. He's scheduled to start at 150. So he may well have to come back out and lift again, the 16-year-old from Uzbekistan, unless he's going to push all the way to 150 as well, which would, based on the lift that we just saw, would seem unlikely, you would think. That lift looked a struggle, didn't it? It looks like 147 is where he's going to go. That's what's on the screen at the moment. They can still change it.
Vahodbek Sobirov, Uzbekistan. A dose there of smelling salts to clear everything.
A magnificent physique.
Yes, not at all like the old weightlifters from decades ago who were really big men.
Yeah.
This guy's a whippet by comparison.
He's not much body fat on him.
But he's got a big task here to try to get to 147. He's got 145 already confidently scoring for him.
But that's only 1 kilo ahead in terms of the context of the competition for the third ranked lifter. Provided, of course, that the Russian makes his. So this will give him a bit of breathing space going into the clean and jerk if he can make it. But it was a struggle at 145.
Sobirov, Uzbekistan.
Oh, that's a lot better lift. Technically, that was a much better lift. Well done. So he's now in at 147 for the snatch. And the one thing that we do know is that our Russian favourite, Gagayev, is going to have to keep coming back out for his three lifts because he's the only active lifter left in the contest. Nice leg drive. That was a terrific lift.
Yes, that's right. The pressure's gone on him in some respects. He's got to keep lifting. Here he is, the number one seed, the number performer, Gitag Kugayev. So Kugayev, Tev, 150 on the bar, having his first start.
Well, that'll do. He had no problem with that whatsoever, did he? So he's got himself a 3 kilo break for now. And when you have a little look at, I don't want to use the word easy, but how comfortably he did that, who knows where he's going to choose to go. He has 2 minutes, of course, when you're lifting consecutively. He has 2 minutes to come back out and start his next lift. Interestingly enough, he's decided to go back in to the warm-up area as opposed to sit on the stool or walk around next to the stage. So he wants to get away from the bright lights at the moment, away from the gaze of the crowd.
There was a little bit of a language problem when they went in to have a chat. The Russian coach wasn't sure what I was saying to him, so he took his passport out and showed me the young man's passport. And of course I couldn't read the, is it Cyrillic writing in the Russian passport? So communication was difficult, but there he is. He's speaking for himself here as he goes to 157 kilograms. That's a 7K improvement. It's going straight back out.
So 150 was really comfortable. You'd expect that this is around his PB. When you talk to lifters, they always like to start comfortably and then move to their PB or around thereabouts and then extend. And we say that in some cases they might be moving to what they're currently lifting as their best lift, but youngsters that would be around their best, but some older lifters, you know, they might not be able to achieve their PB again and they'll be lifting to where they're currently at their best.
And there's quite a bit of hitting and physical activity and manliness and stuff going on too, isn't there?
It's not a testosterone-free zone, that's for sure.
No. Okay. Here we have the Russian now, Gitag Kugayev.
157 on the bar. So he's going to take at least 10 kilo lead from the snatch into the clean and jerk. Throughout the competition, we have the biggest lead that's been pegged back has been 8 kilos. So this is a magnificent performance.
And look, almost a look of disdain towards the bar when he lets it go and lets it drop.
Yeah, there's a bit of a statement being made. And he's hoping that his fellow competitors are watching this inside. He just goes, yeah, that was pretty easy. No problem there. Just making sure that they're a little psyched, if that's possible. and he's going to lift the bar up another 7 kilos. It's just being announced that he's going to go to 164 kilos, so a 14-kilo increase in total from where he started. So this would be a massive lead after the snatch if he was to achieve it.
I noticed that the lifters, the lattice weights there, don't get locked on.
No, those little 1 and 2K, they throw on the end there.
Okay, third straight time. Kugoyev is coming back out. Gitag Kugoyev.
Great looking legs, hasn't he? Legs like well, cyclists often have legs like that, but they don't have the upper body strength that this man has. He's just a magnificent specimen. He's going to get hit in the head by his coach, hit in the back.
Believe me, it's pretty warm in the arena now, in the early evening in Nanjing. Warm and humid outside. It's kind of causing a bit of stuffiness inside, but these boys are attuned to it. Got plenty of time to go. You see in the background the figures counting down.
Yeah, he hasn't even hit the 30-second mark yet.
So here goes Gitag Kugoyev. Well, what do you think of that one?
Oh, I think it's magnificent. It's only
very good.
Yeah, it's only some 7 kilos away from the world record. In fact, is it 6 kilos away from the world record at youth level, which has stood for a decade. That's a really superb lift. And how quick was he? You know, he's 85 kilos. He's nothing but muscle, and he is as quick as lightning. Fantastic lift. So there'll be about a 10-minute break now, but Gagaev at 164 kilos, that is an absolutely massive lead that he'll take in, and that really the battle is for the silver and bronze, unless it's an absolute disaster and he can't manage to get a safe clean and jerk. But you would think he'd come out and do something very safe, confirm the gold medal and then try and push on. But that's a huge lead, isn't it? 164 to 147, but only, you know, 3 kilos between silver and bronze at the moment, and only a couple of kilos between bronze and fourth at the moment. So there's still some interest in this contest, there's no doubt about that. But we'll reset for the clean and jerk. There'll be, just looking at the clock, 8 minutes and 50 odd seconds left for the officials to have a bit of a break and the athletes to get themselves set. So I wonder what they're thinking when you're in a contest and you know that, you know, you're halfway through, and your contest really is about personal best. In terms of if you came here looking at a gold medal, you're thinking that's gone, you know, unless there's a complete disaster for the leader, it's a short. What do you think is going through their mind?
Well, the thing about weightlifting is other people's successes are not your own failures.
Mm.
So you have your standards set, and your coaches know exactly what, or should know exactly what your capabilities are. So at your own level, you can perform with distinction to satisfy yourself.
Yeah, it's one of the great things about measured sports. You know, you can finish eighth in the 100-meter freestyle final, do your best time, and you're a winner. You've come out, you've achieved to a level that you haven't achieved before. And the same thing can certainly be said of weightlifting. It's not a tennis match where someone is at the other end and cleaning you up.
So there's Wang of Korea.
As a young lass from Kazakhstan who we saw competing this morning.
Looking at a medal, is she? Yeah. She got the bronze, did she?
She did, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. She performed well and, of course, had the identical score as the silver medalist, but had weighed in a little more heavily, young man that we saw last night there on screen as well. And one of the coaches from India, Raglan, he performed really well. But yeah, she was 228, I think, wasn't it? Yes, it was.
That's right, exactly the same.
And the other competitor, of course, was lighter.
And still getting congratulations, no doubt. Sitting with the coach there, still getting congratulations from home.
Yeah, there'd be text messages coming through.
Yes.
And so a little bit of a warm-up for the clean and jerk. Interesting technique some of the Eastern Europeans have employed in the clean and jerk throughout the competition of, instead of throwing one foot back, throwing both feet out. It's been something we've seen more of with the taller lifters. Whether it's some issue about the feeling that they've a better chance to keep their back straight and keep themselves in position there. There's a young boy from Poland who lifted a few days ago, and he did nothing but smile. He was like the American girl we saw this morning. He was such an entertainer and really loved his experience.
So the clean and jerk is almost with us. Crucial part of the lift you'll see in the clean and jerk is to get your body under the weight. The clean and jerk, when the bar is poised on the shoulders for the upward push, everything's got to be coordinated, mind, body, repositioning of the hands.
Absolutely. You want a really good, fast, long pull so you can get the bar sitting across your chest. We saw, of course, an incident where perhaps a girl had the bar across her Adam's apple, across her throat a little too high, and had a quick faint. And there was it looks a lot worse because, of course, the barbells ensure that you're not going to hit your head on the with the bar, but it looked worse than what it was. Fortunately, she got up and she was fine, which was good to see. But there's a really a lot of weight being thrown around. When you look at our leader, he's four odd minutes away from a start. He's going to start lifting at 182 kilos in terms of where he's currently thinking. That's a lot of weight for a boy who's less than 85 kilos.
Well, you think of a successful, say, a sprinter, there might be, in athletics, say, there might be 90 kilograms, a strong man.
Mm.
So this is picking up two adults.
Yeah.
And raising them high.
Yeah, these are...
The essence, too, is to get the bar centered.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
And if it fades to one side,
too hard,
then you're really gone, aren't you?
Yeah, the only way you'll manage it if it's faded to one side is if you've sometimes you'll see that with their first lift, if you can just overpower it. But you know, most of these boys, looking at the way they've lifted in the snatch, they've all got good techniques. We've seen, you know, a real shift in. Earlier in the week, we saw a 14-year-old boy from Micronesia, and you know, he's probably been lifting for a few months, and then we've got others that have been, you know, the almost men that have been lifting for 5, 6, 7, 8 years. So it's a big gap. But these five all look technically pretty good.
Just a reminder here, we're in the gap between the snatch competition and the clean and jerk. The clean and jerk to come. We've got five competitors in this category, 85 kilograms, and we really do come in the second half of the weightlifting competition to the competition with a lot of edge, a lot of hard decisions have to be made by the lifters and their assistants, the coaching staff. There's risk taking, a lot of more tactics in the second half of the weightlifting competition.
Absolutely, in particularly in those moments when you can think, well, I'll send you straight back out when someone's maybe made a lift at 160-odd kilos and you're next down at 168, they go to 168, and you say, no, I'll lift at 170. So they've got to suddenly walk back out when they weren't expecting it. And there's, you know, with only five starters, there was that feeling with a couple of the misses in the snatch that it was focused, that they, because the boys then came out and managed to lift more weight on a couple of occasions. But perhaps just the fact that they had to rush through. This man, of course, just sat back and waited for all of them. But the others, a bit of rushing.
A bit of tape in the thumbs there. I guess the fingers are torn around on the edges of the rough edges of the bar.
Absolutely. You can. Technically, you're allowed to wear gloves, but very few lifters ever do. They prefer to tape. And, just because of the feel of the bar in your hands. And, of course, you are entitled to wear the back support, knee supports, and strapping on the elbows if there's an injury. But apart from that, you're on your own. So we shouldn't be far away now. We're just getting an announcement that the first lift will be at 160 kilos.
So there's a reminder of the standings.
Yeah, it's a big weight, isn't it, for the Russian? 164. And the next nearest was 147, was it not? Yep. So the bar being set at 160. And we'll have the Korean, the boy from Seoul, out first.
And with the start of the clean and jerk, the poker begins.
Yeah.
The game of poker. A kind of a tactical to and fro between the leaders as they try to...
Well, I think our Russian might have a full house, though.
He's looking good, all right. Let's see. He's got to get one lift in, doesn't he?
Absolutely.
To make the total.
He's going to make a sensible decision about his first lift.
Okay. Here comes the start of the second half of this 85 kg's gold, silver and bronze medal to be decided at the end of the series of lifts. Here is Wang Songwan of the Republic of Korea, from the massive city of Seoul, which once hosted the Olympic Games. Here he goes. Clean to the chest. Up, 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 up.
Yeah, it's a good lift. And that gets him cleanly underway. With a lift of 160 kilos, he'll go back and have a little think about where he can go next. The next lift is scheduled is at 168, so he'll have a think about where he should place the bar if it is to be Wang Song Wang to come back out. Then he'll have the 2 minutes to do it. But it was a really comfortable lift, and of course Seoul, you know, what a wonderful Olympics they were. Some fantastic performances.
You and I are lucky enough to go there, and yes. Wonderful memories.
A little pocket Hercules in action in the weightlifting.
None of these young men would remember Seoul, of course.
None of them were born.
None of them born at all.
But you know, Vladimir Siannikov, his second 1500 victory, broke 15 minutes, of course, the first man to do so. There were some wonderful performances in Seoul. So he's going to have to come back out. So the bar is set at 163. Looking at his entry total, that's right thereabouts for him.
Is it 165 now?
No, he's gone up. So he's decided, which is... That could give him a break, because I think the boy from Iran may also have to come out unless he decides to go.
Yes, you're right.
It's going to give him a break, yep.
It is. It gives him an extra few minutes of recovery, because the Reza Baralvand is coming out.
And it's interesting that he used a fair bit of that 2 minutes before he decided to go. But now, actually, Baralvand now said, no, I'm going to 169, so he has to come back out at 165. He can't make another decision. He can't make a second one and go further. So he's back out.
So this is the kind of tactics and poker we were talking about in the clean and jerk competition. In an ideal world, I guess Huang would have preferred Baralvand to come next, but... It's really just maybe it's even semantics. He's got to do the job for himself here. 5 kgs more than he lifted a couple of moments ago.
Well, that gives him a 300-kilo total. And he was disappointed with his snatch. He's got a bit more to go, I think, here. I think you might see him go another 5 kilos or so. He would have liked to have got another 5 kilos out of the snatch, but this looks pretty comfortable for him. So he's at 300 kilos now. And he's probably going to push towards 305. He would have been hoping for around the 310 mark when he first came into the competition, but didn't get as much out of the snatch as he would have liked.
But Ralph Hans coming over, just going to take his place on the seats, is he? Or is he getting set to throw? He's gonna lift, rather. Right next.
At 169.
Gee, 169. He's coming in at a very impressive beginning weight. Reza Baralvand, Islamic Republic of Iran. Country with great reputation in sports like the weight sports, this one, wrestling, boxing.
Yep.
...169 kilograms to be hoisted high.
I stood in one action, of course, to the chest, and then well done.
Very well done.
I wonder how comfortable he was. Pretty good. It was a nice clean pull up to the chest. The next scheduled weight is 170. He's obviously going to go further than that, but the next lifter may also choose to do that. We haven't got any rookie weightlifters here when you look at the technique of all these boys.
Okay. There's Fakodvic. Sobirov.
Put this into some perspective. He was ranked second after the snatch, and he's already out for his first attempt in the clean and jerk.
Being watched closely. 10 seconds. Oh, what's... I don't know. Let's have a look.
Yeah, I don't know either. It's going to be okay.
Oh, it's going to be okay.
Yeah, it looked a struggle, didn't it? You were worried about the left arm, I think.
It was.
But that takes him to the number one ranking for the moment.
I was also worried that he was going to lose it at the back.
Yeah. But the referees have seen this cleanly. It was just that, I don't think he's reflexed that elbow. It's okay. And from our vantage point, it looked to be perhaps a question mark that... he's into the contest.
So now we go back to Wang. And he's gone to 170.
We thought he might go there, didn't we, when he was so comfortable at 160 and 165. So this is his final lift for the competition.
Might have been a bit of an injury. Lucky it's his last throw.
Yep.
Bow. Oh, thank you to the crowd. In the manner of the Korean people. And that's a big disappointment for Wang.
Yeah, it is. And you can just see it there. The leg going. So the knee or something has been a problem. But he's going to have to be satisfied with a total of 300. So it's 10 shy of his entry total, 10 shy of where he was no doubt expecting to be. He probably would have been hoping to go past that. This is the second attempt.
Or is it Burrell Fund?
Trying to add another 4 kilos to take him to 317. That would make him equal first at the moment. I'll have a look at the body weights to tell you whether it'll separate them. Yes, it would. He's just lighter than the current number one ranked lifter.
Here he goes at 173 kilograms.
Oof. Come on, steadied it up
and got the three white lights and for a good lift,
and has got the number one ranking for the moment, which puts him right amongst it for the medals.
Well, he's a real fighter and never better shown there. Now, how much more has he got to confirm? Look at this.
It didn't look easy, did it? And it was a real struggle, but as you say, he's a fighter, he's got heart, he's also got another lift up his sleeve.
The other thing, it was a long lift. It took many seconds to complete.
Which you don't want to have happen if you can help it. So a moment ago he was ranked one, he's now ranked two. We've still got a couple of lifters to come out with their first attempts.
So Sobirov of Uzbekistan.
He's currently got the 317 kilo total, which on the basis of body weight has him ranked second. Trying to add 4 kilos.
Level for the push-up. Steadies it, drops it, and gets the three white lights.
And a good call too, because it wasn't perfectly level. He had to absolutely muscle that. But that gets into 321. So the number one ranking, what we're really seeing here in light of what we expect to come is a battle for the bronze. There's a medal on offer here for these two men that are currently in this little battle, and that's he didn't have it quite even, but he muscled it up there. So he's now at 321 and he's gone to number one. A moment ago they were both at 317, but he was number two on the basis of body weight. For Alvin now will probably add enough weight to get himself to the same point of 321, and on the basis of body weight the number one ranking for now, but really we're probably talking about a battle for bronze. That is what he's going to do. He's going to add 4 kilos to the bar, and then he'd be hoping that Sobirov misses his last attempt. So he needs to nail this, hope Sobirov misses, and he could be looking at least a bronze medal, depending on what happens next.
So it's a game of cat and mouse, tactics galore, and coming in is Reza Baralband.
Will this lift be enough for a bronze medal? He'll certainly set a target that his opponent will have to beat.
Here he comes. Oh dear.
Not tonight. And that is his third and final lift. He's been 320 before. He was trying to get himself to 321, which could have been a medal winning lift for him. And you saw he had that second effort there, but by the time you're doing that, you're in a lot of trouble. That's unlucky. So he's with a total of 317, which has him in fourth position.
Okay, here comes Farhodbek Sobirov. Uzbekistan.
Yes, currently ranked first, two lifters to come. So he's going to try and set something that that may challenge. You can tell by the look of this approach that this is a very big weight for him. 177.
Collapse as well.
He was so close to it though, wasn't he? Oh, you're just willing him to be able to steady that bar and keep it up there. He was as Irani, the doctor, coming out to help him out. He was so close.
Well, he had it up.
He did.
And then of course they asked him to go down those steps. If he's a little lightheaded, he could crash down there as well. And meanwhile, Shosha, the next lifter, Mohammed Shosha, look at this.
He's probably in bronze medal position, but who knows what's going to happen ahead of him. They could both miss. He's currently ranked first. He was trying to just set that a little bit further forward, higher, and he was so close, but probably will take bronze. We'll see. It really comes down to how these next two lifters perform.
Shosha now with 178 on the bar. Ooh, nice. Surprise.
And he's got a lot of work to do because he was 140 after the snatch. And Sobirov was 147 after the snatch. So he's got a lot of work to do anyway. So Sobirov is probably looking more likely as a silver where he's sitting at the moment, particularly with this happening here at 178. He needs to now come back and think to himself, do I need to... There's the young lady that was just spectacular last night. Do I need to go further than 178? Because 178 is not going to get the job done.
Well, they're tremendous competitors. We know that.
So this will get him within 4 kilos. It'll get him 4 kilos closer to where he needs to be, but he was 7 kilos behind after the snatch.
Mohammed Shosha, 178, second attempt.
And you asked any weightlifter, they'd much rather be out there making the lift as opposed to watching someone trying to miss it if they had the choice. It's a bit like a golfer wanting to sink the final putt to win as opposed to watching someone miss one. But that's where Sobirov is now. He's watching this man and hoping that he can't lift at 178 and go further. Currently in first position, potential silver or bronze medal.
Center up under the chin. Oh no.
Nope, never got that steady. Gee, isn't he under pressure now? And of course, if he misses now, that brings the other two boys right into contention as well. Rivaldon, it looked like he would nail this, didn't he? He just didn't get that leg back quickly enough. And then started to get the wobbles, didn't have the back straight enough.
I reckon he'll get it third time out.
Well, I hope for him he does.
Yeah, absolutely. Got to remember at all times that these are very young, let's call them kids.
Exactly. And the weight that he's at will currently claim second position, which, based on what the Russian did earlier, you would think is probably a bronze medal. He would have been thinking to himself where he started at 178 that he would be challenging for silver, but Sobirov now is is in first position, and if the Russian comes out and does what we expect him to do properly, silver. So this man's about to come out and try and lift for a bronze medal. But Prevaldin from Iran, he's right in the calculations at the moment. He's currently sitting in second position and waiting to see what the Egyptian can do. And get some pace back into those legs.
You saw them flapping him with the towel before. It's very close, it's very warm in this expo hall tonight. And people in the crowd recognize this is a critical moment here for Mohamed Shosha and his hopes for Egypt. 178. He really needs total here, so he has to get this. Oh, comfortable to there. How do you like that?
Yeah, and a wonderful response from the crowd too. And that is a successful lift and gets himself into the silver medal position for the moment. That is his last lift. He won't be able to improve on 318. So Sobrevov, there's some tears there. He knows he's going to get a medal one way or another. At the moment, probably looking at bronze, but that was a huge lift, having missed twice at 178. It gets into a total of 318. So one more than the boy from Iran. And aren't they happy? And now all on this man, who has to make a clean lift to give himself a total, and he's lifting at 180.
Yes, we saw the reaction on the replay of the other coach in exasperation at the success of Shosha. And that'll do it. Thank you for Getag Kugalev.
Yeah, that was so easy, wasn't it? So that now settles the little discussion we were having a moment ago. So he's now taken the number one ranking. He's the only active lifter still in the contest. So Sobrevov is sitting with silver. And the lifter that came out and nailed that 178 that we're talking about,
Shosha
has a bronze medal for now. So they're confirmed, barring any sort of nonsense or disaster. But this man has 344 kilos in total. His nearest competitor is 321. The one after that is 318. He's a long way in front. And he's made a successful lift at 180. And we suggested he do something pretty within himself and pretty safe. Look at where he's gone.
He's gone way up to 191, which is interesting because his coach told me that there was a language difficulty, whether it was a personal best total or whether it was his entry total, it was 182. So he's gone way past that. Having a swig of the sponsor's products. Getting set to come out into these steamy conditions here tonight in Nanjing. It's really warm.
Yeah, it's been quite cool in the venue to this point, and but it's been a much hotter day today outside, and the air conditioning hasn't done the job that it's done in the last few days. The athletes have been rugged up. But up tonight, Kagayev approaching the bar at 191 in the clean and jerk. He already has first place wrapped up. And he's just trying to extend his personal best. Big lift. Another no-nonsense approach, though.
So, here he comes, Kugayev. He hasn't missed on a lift tonight. He continues to show his class. That's 191.
Yeah, he doesn't look like missing, does he? We'll see where he goes next. Again, he'll have 2 minutes to think about it. But Well, that didn't look any less comfortable than the 180 lift.
You're right.
Great technique. Back was always straight. Took long arms for his height. And so they're now making the announcement of where he'll go. And it looks like 195. So that would give him a combined total of 359 should he be successful at 195 in the clean and jerk. Already has first place wrapped up. So he's trying to add a new total to the gold medal that they'll be putting around his neck in 10 minutes' time. Oh, no, he's going further. 201.
Going massively high increase.
Isn't that funny? They made the announcement at 195. They got the officials to change the weight, and then he went, well, no, hang on, I can go a bit more than that. I'll just add another 6 kilos. So 21 kilos from where he started, which was a smart start. He knew he just needed to get a successful lift in the clean and jerk to claim first place. So he did that well within himself, and now he's 21 kilos beyond where he started.
Well, let me tell you, when he was born, 21st of October 1997. So that's a couple and a bit, two and a bit years till the turn of the century, and then 14 years and 8 months. So do the math. 16 years and 10 months. Getag Kugayev.
Do you think anyone steals his lunchbox in the playground?
I don't think so. Clearing the head.
16-year-old schoolboy. Look at him.
So, this is the last lift of the competition. The gold medal is his. But can he really lift the lid?
Yeah, it'd be a bit of an exclamation mark on it, wouldn't it? At 201 for a total of 365.
Here's another thing I like. He's got a really good concentration, really good game manner, game face. And up it goes. Fighting it. Oh, no. Great effort. Bold effort. It won't get him the lift. He gets the three red lights, but he gets the gold medal. He takes that one home to Russia. Getag Kugayev. Fantastic effort. Yes. And a bold finish.
It sure was. And a total of 355 kilos. He's 34 kilos to the good of the silver medalist. Gee, it looked like he was going to get there, didn't it? But just didn't get that left foot back under the shoulder quickly enough. And that led to the couple of extra steps, and then down it went. But that's a magnificent performance nonetheless. 355 kilos for Gagaev, the Russian. And
Once it starts to kind of oscillate up the top there,
gone, yeah.
You've got no control, and he had to put it down or let it go.
But Sobarov from Uzbekistan, his lifting was very good as well, and he was involved in that little tete-a-tete with Shosha, so he takes the silver medal with 321 kilos, and the Egyptian with 318 kilos, just 1 kilo to the good in the end of the young boy from Iran, who looked to be well out of it, but then when some things started going awry for the other competitors, had a chance. There's the weights as well in the end. No ties in terms of total, so the body weights didn't come into it. And we'll be back shortly with our gold, silver and bronze medalist and the medal ceremony for the men's 85 kilo weightlifting.
Well, it was a contest that had many, many highlights.
School kids having a bit of fun, and we're just going to wait for the podium to be erected on the platform, and then our athletes will make their way out to collect their medals.
Fanfare for the victory ceremony for the men's 85 kilogram weightlifting at the second Summer Olympic Games, the Youth Summer Olympic Games, Nanjing 2014.
It's certainly not a fanfare for the common man, because Gagaev is anything but performance, 34 kilos above his nearest competitor.
And there he is, tucked in behind Mohammad Shosha. Shosha will take the bronze, and Vahodvik Shobirov will take the silver. We're talking about poker face, poker being a tactic in the clean and jerk. Well, he's the man with the poker face, the winner, isn't he?
Yeah, he gives nothing away. And in both the clean and jerk and the snatch, of course, he had to come out and make three successive lifts. He at least, I suppose, always knew that would be the case. Yeah, he wasn't sitting back waiting for other athletes to lift before him. In between these lifts.
So there's Mrs. Aisha Garad Ali from Djibouti, a member of the International Olympic Committee. And she'll present the medals, accompanied by Kendrick Farris of the International Weightlifting Federation.
Tremendous lifter himself, of course.
Thank you.
So there's your bronze medalist, Mohamed Shosha from Egypt.
Got there by just a kilo. That's all he needed. 318. Fourth place was 317. He lifted 140 in the snatch and 178 in the clean and jerk.
So there he is, Fahodbek Sovirov. Proud moment for Uzbekistan with a silver medal.
Yes, he had a few anxious moments when the bronze medalist had an attempt to match his weight.
So let's see what sort of a victory smile we get from our winner, Gitag Kugayev. Maybe he's thinking already of the next competition.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if he's an unassuming sort of fellow. He looks...
looks shy, doesn't he?
He does. He does look shy.
What a thrill from Demet. A great champion. So now we're going to hear that tremendous anthem of the Russian Federation. One of the most stirring ones you'd hear anywhere. So, Gitag Kugayev, deserving winner of the gold medal. Yes, congratulations to a very fine lifter, Gitag Kugayev, Russian Federation gold medalist in the 85 kilogram weightlifting class here at 2014 Nanjing Youth Olympic Games.
Pretty nonchalant approach to his achievement. He's lifting at the sort of numbers that you would think would see him go right on with a career. Who knows whether Rio will be too soon for him, but he's not that far away, depending on how he develops over the next couple of years. But he's going to be a good lifter for some time to come, as will the other boys. Hope we see more of them on the world stage as well.
So it might have been a small field, but a good crowd that came to the Expo Center enjoyed a tight competition until Kugayev got cracking and then pulled off those big lifts to push him out to a significant winning margin, and he deservedly takes the Journey of Honor, Gitag Kugayev, of the Russian Federation gold medalist in the 85 kilogram class.